All around the world, with the continued rise in craft beer, there are so many wonderful breweries that deserve at the very least a visit. Consider this series your guide to globetrotting the best of the world's craft beer scene. Okay, so you see, I'm standing on the porch of Dr. van der Korenaar. Okay, but that side. This is Netherlands. That side's Belgium. This side's Netherlands. How cool is that?
Hallo, ik ben Ronald van brouwerij De Dochter van de Korenaar en ik mag hier de brouwer zijn bij deze brouwerij. Ik ben ook de eigenaar samen met mijn vrouw. En ik maak hier een grote verscheidenheid aan bieren. Sinds 2007 zijn we op de markt en de bieren lopen uiteen van een 3% licht blond bier tot een 13% zware barley wine. En zo'n beetje alles daartussenin. De reden daarvoor is dat ik het leuk vind om af en toe wat anders te maken. En dat komt misschien uit mijn verleden als chef-kok, dat ik ook niet iedere dag hetzelfde wil koken. Zo wil ik niet iedere dag hetzelfde type bier moeten maken, maar is het leuk om wat variëteit aan te brengen. En een van de variëteiten die ik graag doe, dat is het bier laten rijpen op eikenhouten tonnen. En dat kan gaan van whisky of jenevervaten, in ieder geval sterke drankvaten, tot witte wijnvaten, rode wijnvaten. En ook sinds een aantal jaren gebruiken we nieuwe houten vaten. Dat geeft een grote verscheidenheid aan aan smaken aan het bier af en een zekere rondheid en zachtheid aan de bieren. En dat is leuk om mee te spelen. Natuurlijk maar een klein deel van de productie. Een van de filosofieën is om een drinkbaar bier te maken. Kijk, je kunt een hele mooie smaak aan je bier geven, maar als je na een paar slokken zegt van dat was lekker, maar ik hoef niet meer, dan vind ik niet dat je een goed bier hebt. Ik vind een goed bier dat bier waarvan je graag een tweede glas zou willen hebben. Dus als je glas leeg is en je zegt van dat was verdomd lekker, doe mij nog maar een glas.
As you know, we're here at Dr. van der Korenaar. I'm here with my buddy Ronald, and you know, it's actually sad that I'm only doing focus on one special and beautiful beer. But if you come to Dr. van der Korenaar, you are so spoiled for choice because Ronald does so many crazy experimentations and stuff that you know you could probably not do it all in one sitting. You'd have to come 3-4 days in a row of serious drinking to actually be able to we'll see what this man has got going on. So, Ronald, you're going to pour us one.
Yeah. So nice. I tell you first about the beer?
Huh? Okay, while you're pouring. Need to get some of this beer in my system.
This is one of my barrel-aged beers. And a very special one. Made with 100% Maraschino malt. And then hopped with Iskan Golding hops. So it's an English IPA. It's hopped to crazy extents. And then, strangely, for an IPA, it's barrel aged for 1.5 years. Like the original IPA, how they did it. But there's a strange modern twist to it.
Yeah.
It's aged in Pouligny Montrachet barrels, so white Burgundy barrels.
Oh, wow.
Very famous white Burgundy.
Yeah, absolutely. I got it. I'm 100% on the page with you. Yeah.
And prior to filling, 1 week prior to filling, we dry off it with a little bit of Nelson Sauvin, just to enhance the Sauvignon Blanc character a little bit, and to get the hoppiness a little bit back, and fruitiness. And then you get this slightly sour, very hoppy beer. At the beginning, when you brew this beer after fermentation, the IBU is about 150. You can't break it.
Yeah.
After 1.5 years, we got still, we still got some 50 IBU left.
Wow, man.
So it's still a hoppy beer.
Yeah.
But it's far more balanced. It's nice, fruity, mellow.
Wow, look at this. Serving glasses, really cool. Ronald, cheers. Let's have a look at this beer. Pour is absolutely crystal clear. Gentle carbonation. Oh, a nose that's fruity. Definitely got the vanilla flavor from the barrel on the nose as well. So I'm drinking a beer that's 1.5 years old.
No, this one is in bottle for half a year now.
It's 2 years.
It's 2 years old.
Two-year-old beer. Are you getting this, Ronald? So the smell is appealing. See what it tastes like.
Funny, when you taste this beer next to the wine, you can clearly
taste
that it's brother and sister.
That is incredible. Imagine an IPA that tastes like it's like semi-IPA flavor. Then you've got this grape flavor as well. You've got this barrel flavor on top of it. It is. It's like a blend between a wine and a beer.
No.
Oh,
I can live with that.
Oh yeah, I'm totally on the page with that.
And
one,
it's
yeah?
And it's the best freaking beer to go with oysters. Can you imagine?
I can see that. No, I can.
Do
I
you
can
like oysters?
Love oysters. Love it.
We tried this with champagne. We tried oysters with champagne.
Yeah.
With Pouligny Montrachet. With Chablis. And with this beer. And with this beer, it just matches. It's a perfect match.
This is absolutely divine. And as he told you in the beginning, Ronald was actually previously a chef, and hence him talking about food pairings as well. You know, I've been lucky enough to spend the entire afternoon with him, and you know, when we have lunch, we're discussing. Yeah, eating and drinking. Job description, what can I tell you? So, as brewers would say, it's an occupational hazard. So, but this is absolutely, and you won an award for this, didn't you?
Yeah.
The Zythos?
Yeah, the Zythos Consumers Award 2016.
Zythos? Yeah.
The largest beer festival in Belgium, where about 16,000-17,000 people.
Yeah.
They get to pick the best beer of the festival. So in fact, you can say it's maybe the best beer of Belgium of that year.
Wow, man.
And,
well, it's people who are paying for it, so they would know, you know? But I tell you what, this beer absolutely deserves every accolade it gets. This is so masterfully crafted. And 2 years. 2 years.
It still tastes fresh.
Yeah, it's still... I'll tell you what, though, it's very complex. So you've got all these little notes, and they don't muddle. They come together in this sort of parade on your palate. Ronald, thank you so much, man.